your head like a hero on a history book page. It was the end of a decade, but the start of an age.
Good evening, Farmington. Welcome to the 140th commencement ceremony at Farmington High School. My name is John Lunn. I'm interim principal here for the 9th and 10th graders at Farmington High School and would love to welcome everyone here tonight. Before we get started here, I have a couple of announcements for the audience and the parents. Please remember that only graduates, the seniors, are allowed on the turf, on the stadium turf, during the ceremony. After the ceremony, the graduates will be picking up their diplomas in the auxiliary gym, and then they'll be right back out here for all sorts of pictures. Lynn Halterman Images will be taking a picture of each senior receiving their diploma. A proof picture will be available on the studio's website. Students receive this information on Schoology. It's available on the school website under Senior Guide and was shared with the most recent S'more newsletters. And the accessibility by scanning, and is accessible by scanning the QR codes found around the stadium. Again, we ask that parents and guests please do not come onto the stadium turf to take pictures during the ceremony. As a reminder, the seniors will be walking in with their college and career readiness class, not alphabetically. They will also be announced by their CCR teacher as they walk across the stage. CCR is the one class where students and a teacher remain together for 4 years, and in many cases, students and their teachers have bonded. We feel that this is a great way to showcase and celebrate together the hard work and the dedication of the students and their teachers. I know that this is an exciting time for everybody here. It's an exciting time for the graduates and their families, but we really need everyone's cooperation for this. When your graduate's name is called, please, please refrain from loud shouting, whistling, use of air horns, etc. This graduation is a formal recognition ceremony, and we want all families to hear their student's name, hear it read as an important day for everyone and them as well. If you need to get it out of your system, we're gonna try this right now. I wanna hear the greatest Farmington woo on three. One, two, three, woo! Not bad, not bad. The evening will have floral arrangements adorning the stage. One very special arrangement located to my right on the corner of the stage is an all-white arrangement designed and created in remembrance of all of those unable to be with us this evening. Whether a graduate or a student of the class of 2023, family member, grandparent, parent, or significant other, we dedicate this beautiful arrangement in remembrance of those loved ones. Finally, at this time, please turn off your pagers. I almost skipped that. Silence your cell phones, smartwatches, and anything else. For all the mothers, families, get out your Kleenexes, because we're about ready to get this party started. This is a milestone event in the lives of our seniors and their families. We are all very proud of their accomplishments. Sit back and enjoy tonight's ceremony. I will be right back with the class of 2023.
When I wake Good evening and welcome to the 140th Annual Farmington High School Commencement Ceremony. My name is Laura Pierce, Interim Principal for Grades 11 and 12 here at Farmington High School. Please rise and join me in welcoming the class of 2023. Would our staff please lead the students into the stadium?
Thank you.
At this time, I would ask the audience to please remain standing for the presentation of colors, followed by the national anthem. Thank you, members of the FHS graduation band. Under the direction of Miss Erin Holmes, members of New Dimension Choir, under the direction of Miss Megan Dimich, and the FHS drum majors for the presentation of colors. Now at this time, will the audience and the class of 2023 please be seated. Next, I would like to introduce Abby Radesky, our 2023 Student Council President, to begin our ceremony with this year's senior reflection. Abby will be attending the University of North Dakota, majoring in biology, professional health sciences, with a minor in psychology. She's the president of the Student Council on the Capital Division Council, Regional Student Council Board, National Honor Society, Concert Choir, and a Link Crew leader. Abby was also enrolled in the MNCAPS healthcare pathway. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Abby Radesky.
Hello, everyone. For those of you who might not know me, my name is Abby Radesky, and I am your 2023 Student Council President. Before I begin, I would like to give a huge thank you to all the people who not only set up this wonderful graduation ceremony, but to all of the people who have supported the class of 2023 on their high school journey. As for my fellow graduates, you should all be extremely proud of yourselves. We finally made it to graduation. Rewinding back to our freshman year, everything seemed so long ago. We walked through these halls for the first time, not knowing what the year would bring us. From football games to spirit weeks, to the performances. Our class wanted to experience everything for themselves and begin to shape themselves into who they wanted to be, even with our first year of high school being cut short. Sophomore year brought its own set of challenges with hybrid and distance learning. Everything we once took for granted seemed a little more uncertain, but our class found the strength and power through all of the adversity that faced us. Moving on to junior year, our class was ready for things to be different. Many of us went to our first prom, our first sporting events again, and our future started to look a little brighter than it was before. At some point, we all began to realize that our high school journey was halfway done, and that filled us with a sense of confidence that no one can match, not even the confidence of the freshmen who thought they could sneak their way to the front of the football games. After 4 years, we reach our senior year, a year of lasts. The last first day of school, the last sporting event, the last spirit week, the last prom, the last homework assignment, the last of everything. Finally, that leads us to where we are today, graduation. If I could give one word to describe the class of 2023, it would be resilient, because through all of the adversity and uncertainty, our class had the resiliency to become the wonderful human beings we are today. No matter where your post-high school journey may take you, I wish you all the best of luck, the class of 2023. Thank you.
Thank you, Abby. Congratulations to the class of 2023, and welcome to all the families, friends, faculty that's here this evening, and community members who have provided support and encouragement to our seniors throughout their educational experience, leading to this occasion, their high school graduation. At this time, I'd like to introduce our school officials and special guests who are seated with me on the stage. Board members Hannah Simmons, Kyle Christensen, Jacqueline Doyle, Becky DeWilde, Melissa Gorman, and Maggie Storley. We also have Superintendent Jason Berg and our faculty speaker, Matthew Grove. Finally, a really big thank you to the following: Mike Burton, Jeff Thompson, Tony Claris, and our ISD 192 custodial staff for this entire setup that started yesterday morning. All of our FHS administrative assistants who tirelessly plan all of the fine details to pull off this magnificent event. And Mark Tauchi, Randy Mathis for running cable, producing, and all the things to make this event live streamed tonight and recorded for those that are unable to be with us. Thank you all for coming tonight to join in this celebration outside. What a glorious night. Can you imagine what a beautiful evening that we're having in Tiger Stadium? The stadium has been the location for all kinds of triumphs, tribulations, and celebrations for many years now. We have won championships here, lost championships, hosted graduations, senior nights, senior sunrise, and sunset, which I got to participate in the first time in my life last night, hosted youth camps, and much, much more. Now it's come the time to celebrate you, each one of you, the class of 2023 and all your accomplishments. As you sit before us today, ready to receive your high school diplomas, I want to take a moment to reflect on the journey that has brought you to this momentous occasion. You entered high school as a freshman. You were bright-eyed, eager, ready to learn and grow. You arrived excited and possibly yet with nervous energy, wondering what high school was like after your middle school years. We could feel your energetic enthusiasm to connect with friends and teachers while being excited for all the amazing opportunities and classes offered here at FHS. And over the past 4 years, you set out to better yourselves and thrive by challenging yourselves academically, socially, and emotionally, and you have emerged as strong, capable, young adults. Along the way, you faced obstacles and overcome many challenges. You persevered during your 9th and 10th grade years, working remotely during a global pandemic. You have experienced the joy of success and the disappointment of mistakes or failures. You've formed new friendships and deepened existing ones, and you've become part of a larger community that has supported you, challenged you, and inspired you to be your best selves. As you depart today for the last time as a FHS student and become an alumni in a little less than an hour, I want to offer you a few words of wisdom that I hope will serve you well in the years to come. First and foremost, always remember that you are capable of achieving great things. You have already accomplished so much, and there's no limit to what you can achieve if you set your mind to it. Believe in yourself, and don't let anyone else tell you that you can't do something. Secondly, remember that mistakes or failure are not the end of the world. In fact, they are often a necessary part of the journey to success. Don't be afraid to take risks, and don't be discouraged if you stumble along the way. Learn from your mistakes and keep moving forward. Third, remember that you're part of a larger community, whether it's your family, your friends, or your future colleagues. There are people around you who care about you and want to see you succeed. Don't be afraid to ask for help when you need it, and don't forget to lend a helping hand to others when you can. Fourth, always be willing to learn and grow. The world is constantly changing, and you must be willing to adapt and evolve if you want to succeed. Be curious, be open-minded, and be willing to step outside of your comfort zone. And finally, and last, never forget the importance of kindness. In a world that can often be harsh and unforgiving, a little bit of kindness can go a long way. Treat others with respect, empathy, and compassion, and you will find that the world becomes a better place for everyone. As you move on to the next phase of your lives, I encourage you to keep these things in mind. Remember the lessons you've learned here and use them to help you navigate the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. And remember that you will always be a part of the school community. You are leaving us physically, but you will always be a member of the class of 2023. We will be here to support you as you continue your journey, and we look forward to seeing all that you accomplish in the years to come. Congratulations, class of 2023. You have made us proud, and we can't wait to see what great things you will achieve in the future. Okay, enough of that. Let's celebrate. To continue the celebration, I am pleased to welcome ISD 192 Superintendent Mr. Jason Berg, who will now share some words of welcome and reflection.
Actually, Ms. Pierce, there's more of that. We have more of that coming here. So good evening. I usually start with a bald joke, but since the classic pager joke went over so well when Mr. Lund was speaking, I'll just skip right to my speech here. So I'm proud to share this significant milestone with the class of 2023. As you sit here ready to begin your new adventures, you have learned many things. You have gained academic knowledge. You have learned critical thinking skills, collaboration skills, time management, and many more. But I want to talk to you about one trait that is often overlooked, regardless of what path you choose. And it is one that we should all aspire towards. This is usually where I get really profound, but tonight it's going to be very simple. That can also be very difficult given the circumstances we sometimes find ourselves in. What am I talking about? I'm talking about simply being a good person. Being a good person is a lifelong journey that involves a combination of mindset, values, and actions. No matter where you are now or where you find yourself in the future, I believe these four principles are practices that can be incorporated into your life at any point in time to help us all become better people. Number one, be honest and trustworthy. Cultivate a reputation of honesty by being truthful and keeping your promises. Build trust with others through not only your words, but more importantly, your actions. Do what you say you will do and always follow through. Number two, show gratitude. Take time to appreciate the people and the things in your life. Express thankfulness and acknowledge the kindness and support that you receive from others. It is amazing how a simple thank you can go a long ways. Practice forgiveness. Let go of the bitterness and hard feelings no matter what comes your way. Learn to forgive others for their mistakes, but more importantly, learn to forgive yourselves. Often we are way harder on our own person than we are on others on the outside. And number four, help others. Look for opportunities to assist others in need. Volunteer your time, your skills, or your resources to make a positive impact on the lives of others. Remember, your character is revealed on how you treat others that can do nothing for you. Congratulations, class of 2023. Today is not an end, it is a beginning. That's actually why they call it a commencement, the beginning. I have no doubt that each of you will go out and make your community a better place. Thank you and good luck.
Thank you, Superintendent Berg. Our student speaker, Tyler Weinberger, was selected by the faculty from the 52 students recognized as distinguished scholars this year. Tyler will be attending Minnesota State University Mankato and majoring in sports management. He's been a member of the FHS Faith Club, National Honor Society, Link Crew Leader, and Student Council member. If that isn't enough, Tyler has played hockey, most recently Junior Gold B, cross country, track and field, and golf. Tyler has been a very positive leader at FHS, and we are all better for knowing him. Ladies and gentlemen, your student speaker, Tyler Weinberger.
How are we doing, everybody? My name is Tyler Weinberger, and I am honored to be speaking in front of all of you today. Honestly, when I found out I was nominated as our class speaker, I had a solid two thoughts cross my mind. Yeah, just two thoughts. So the first here was, wow, this is probably the most important homework assignment I will ever have. And secondly, truthfully, it was the realization of how surreal it is to be up here today. I express extreme gratitude for this opportunity to each of my classmates, friends, family, and God above all else. Everyone, give yourselves as well as your fellow classmates a round of applause. We did it! Tonight, we will all walk across the stage as members of the class of 2023. We have officially conquered high school together, and I would like to leave you with three pieces of advice I have picked up throughout my time in Farmington. In order to demonstrate my first point, I'm going to need some quick audience participation. Would everyone who went to Bachman Middle School please raise their hand? There we go. You know, I'm kind of a rival here, but good for you guys. How about Dodge Middle School? Yeah, that's me. Woo! Somewhere else in Minnesota? I see you. How about a different country or state entirely? Okay, there we go. We got a few hands. Let's go. That's awesome. We clearly have some deep variety among our class, right? But regardless of where you finished those glorious years of middle school, we all felt it. We were on top of the world, right? We were heading to the high school now. I mean, we were far too old and mature for those buildings and little middle schoolers, sixth and seventh graders. Gosh. Man, we thought we would own FHS. We quickly discovered that we, in fact, did not own FHS, and the upperclassmen had no problem showing us that we were the underclassmen. We were first humbled at football games, then in the hallways, and then in lunch lines, and so on and so forth. So, yeah, how does middle school sound now? Not too bad, huh? My point is that in life, you need to know when it's your time to be the underclassmen. I know that's unpopular considering the connotation with freshman year, but here's the thing. We are all going to be in situations at some point or another where we are the least knowledgeable individual in the room. We will be the newbie, the rookie, the intern, call it what you want. We will need to learn. And that's just it. Be a lifelong learner. Continually strive to ask questions, get answers, and learn from those around you. Don't be too proud to experience necessary growth. And remember, it takes being an underclassman to be an upperclassman. And that statement alone actually brings me to my next point. You have to know when to be an upperclassman. We know how it felt walking into FHS on Tuesday, September 6th, 2022, the first day of senior year. Our chins held high, our senior shirts on, and our Instagram page is filled with hashtag SPS for the first few weeks of fall. What a glorious time to be alive. With that day, however, came some new responsibilities, some new challenges even. Those little 9th and 10th graders were now looking up to us, whether they wanted to admit it or not. They watched our every action and interaction, looking up to us as an example. This was huge, the eyes of 1,000 kids on our backs. And this continued all year long. I sure remember looking up to the upperclassmen as a freshman in high school, and there were certain kids I was absolutely inspired by. Those that I looked up to were inclusive, encouraging, responsible, and dedicated to serving others. Looking forward, be ready when given the opportunity to lead others. Take it, run with it, and don't take for granted the chance to guide those beneath you. Instead, dedicate yourself to their growth and guide them as they take on new challenges and circumstances. Be impactful. Use your opportunities to help inspire others toward a successful future so that they may one day lead a group as well. This brings one of my favorite quotes to mind by Maya Angelou. I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. When people look back at how you chose to participate in their life, they will remember exactly how each and every interaction you had with them left them feeling. Were they better off? Worse off? Indifferent? I challenge you, class of 2023, to seize your opportunity as upperclassmen in life. I also challenge you to impactfully lead others when opportunities arise. Don't take them for granted. Don't take advantage of others. And don't forget your responsibility for the growth of those around you. Our lives are not only about us. For my third and final point, I want to bring all of your minds back to that lovely time between 11 a.m. and 12:35 p.m. every school day. Lunchtime. That's my favorite time of day. Now, I want to take that thought a little farther. Maybe you were the A-luncher that went to Cane's twice a week, or maybe you were the spicy chicken patty fanatic. You all know who you are. Maybe you were a salad connoisseur, or maybe you simply enjoyed a packed lunch from home. Regardless, we all ate lunch. The immense range in our preferences surrounding something as simple as our lunch choice displays how unique we all are. In a similar way, we could look at style preferences, hobbies, passions, and so on. Maybe you enjoy nature. Maybe you've got the best fashion in town. Maybe you have 47 different pairs of Converse, or maybe you just wear out that one pair of tennis shoes until next fall. Maybe you're the homework procrastinator, or maybe you're the reason Starbucks is doing so well. Truthfully, this list of things we enjoy points out something very important. We are all so different. We have different hobbies, different passions, different joys, different talents, and most importantly, different gifts. Tonight, think about your gifts, talents, passions, and how you can use those abilities to better those around you. In the book of Romans, chapter 12, verses 6 through 8, Paul wrote, "In his grace, God has given us different gifts for doing certain things well. So if he has given you the ability to prophesy, speak out with as much faith as he has given you. If your gift is serving others, serve them well. If you are a teacher, teach well. If your gift is to encourage others, be encouraging. If it is giving, give generously. If God has given you leadership ability, take the responsibility seriously. And if you have a gift for showing kindness to others, do it gladly." Class of 2023, it doesn't matter what you end up doing. It truly doesn't. Determine your passions, pursue them wholeheartedly, and continually commit to whatever gifts you have been given. I want to encourage each and every one of you tonight with the idea that you have a blessing over your life. It is just up to you to find what that is. Before I close, I would like to take a moment to personally thank every teacher, member of the custodial staff, lunch crew, and faculty, our parents, and everyone else who made these 4 years in Farmington High School the joy that it was. It wasn't always easy, and there wasn't always a clear sight through this journey, but you have all provided so much help, support, and encouragement to our class in this small amount of time. We will be forever grateful for your presence in this stage of our life. Lastly, to my fellow seniors, I would like to thank you all for making these 4 years what they were. I will never forget the impact you have all made in my life. In closing, embrace your time as underclassmen. Be lifelong learners and never allow pride to stunt your growth. Next, live up to the challenge of living as an upperclassman, continuing to lead with wholehearted passion when opportunities arise. Lastly, know that you matter and you are uniquely created with a purpose. You are all so wonderfully gifted, and I encourage you, in whatever it is you end up doing, do it well and do it gladly. Thank you all so much for listening to me tonight, and let's party hard!
Thank you, Tyler. Magnificent. Really appreciate that. Our faculty speaker this evening is Mr. Matthew Grove. Mr. Grove was selected by the senior class to address the graduates on this special occasion. Mr. Grove earned his bachelor's degree from Gustavus Adolphus College in secondary social studies education and master's degree from St. Mary's University in education. He was the 2017 Farmington Public Schools Teacher of the Year. This will be his fourth time addressing the senior class as the teacher graduation speaker. He has been fortunate enough to travel to 30 plus countries and taught in classrooms in 5 different countries around the world. And if that isn't enough, he's been chased by a rhino, had food stolen from his hands by a baboon, and climbed the tallest mountain in Africa, as well as ridden on the top of trains and chicken buses in various countries. Now that I would have liked to have seen. Please help me welcome our 2023 faculty speaker, Mr. Matthew Grove.
Holy smokes, this is quite the view, and pretty cool to be here. It's an honor to be with you, and it's an honor like you wouldn't believe to be here with you, and be with you in front, or to be in front of you this evening. I believe I speak for all of your teachers and support staff over the years by saying how proud we are of you. Each and every one of you is about to embark on your own unique journey. And all of us are beyond impressed with what you have achieved. As I sat and to reflect and prepare over the last several weeks for this very evening, I realized that graduation is about so much more than just a ceremony of rituals, walking across the stage, getting a diploma, and eventually throwing your hat in the air. That is all fine and well, and there's a place for that. But tonight, this very moment, you see, tonight is about coming together as a community to collectively celebrate and lift you up for who you are and what you will become as you take on the future. Now, a warning. Benefit. I'm the last speaker. Then we start going through your names. So we're almost there, all right? But here's the warning. Most graduation speeches involve an audience sitting and listening, but we're going to change that. This is not one of those. I'm going to ask you to participate in a few things over the next few minutes. And just as I do in class, I encourage you to embrace the unusual and find comfort in the uncomfortable. For those of you in the audience, you're not off the hook. I encourage you to join in as well. The first thing I invite you to do, and I mean this, I want you to join me. Take a few deep breaths as you roll your shoulders back and down. Now continue taking nice, slow breaths in and out. Next, place your hand on your chest and feel the rise and fall as you inhale and exhale. Observe the feeling of the seat below you. Observe the feeling of your feet touching the ground. Take a moment to listen to the soundtrack of this evening. the little chatter in the background, the mosquito buzzing next to your ear. For the duration of this evening, I encourage you to continue anchoring yourself in the breath and the sensations of the present moment. You see, throughout tonight and the coming days, as you attend grad parties and spend time with family that have come from down the street or far away, remember to slow down. Take those deep breaths. Be observant of your experience. Soak up this moment. Soak up the moment you find yourself in. The future will be there for you. So don't find yourself rushing to get somewhere or do something else. Look, I know I'm supposed to give you advice to work hard, get a good job, be successful, and so on and so forth. But until we can actually slow down long enough to embrace each moment, the future means nothing. My encouragement to you is that in each moment of your life, the happy moments, the sad moments, the I just can't keep going moments, check in with your breath. Check in with the present moment. And you may find more joy and beauty than you expected. Live by that model and the future will fall into place. As many of you know, this year marks the end of my time at Farmington High School as well, as I will be relocating to a school community in my neighborhood of Minneapolis next year. This speech and ceremony today are not about me, but as I reflect on my time here, I find parallels and similarities to the experience you are having right now as a graduate. In my very first year of teaching here, 13 years ago, the same year that most of you were in kindergarten, I was given a t-shirt that read, "Once a tiger, always a tiger." I always thought it was a bit cheesy, to be honest. My friends made fun of me when I would wear it. But the truth is that I've come to find validity and sincerity in these words. Over my years here, I've met countless people that have modeled for me what it means to be present. And to have the encouragement to enjoy every moment, to seek joy in every small thing we do. Because when we take a deep breath and find curiosity in this moment, I promise you that the next moment will be even sweeter. When I think further about the idea of once a tiger, always a tiger, it reminds me of the belief that we are the sum of all the people we have ever met. This is true of the person to your left. Go ahead and give them a look. The person to your right, and all the other graduates in these chairs tonight. I'm immeasurably grateful to have you in my life, to be the product of our interactions, and I hope you find gratitude for those around you as well, because we're all the sum of the people in our lives. With that being said, and again, audience, this goes for you as well, don't forget. With the same authenticity and the same intention as you put towards those breaths we took together a little bit ago, I want you to take a moment, and I really do mean this, take a moment, and I want you to turn to the person to your left and to the right, give them a fist bump or a handshake, or maybe put your arm around their shoulder, give them a huge smile, and I want you to say to them, "I'm glad you're here tonight." Go ahead. Good work. I love this, right? This is what we need to do. Express our feeling of gratitude and love for one another. I hope you observed how awesome that felt. Because my friends, this moment, this very moment, is the best moment of our lives, just as the next moment will be, and the moment after that. So continue to be present. Especially with the people around you in each moment, and the future will bring you unlimited outcomes. I love you, and I'm gonna miss you more than you can even imagine. Thank you.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you, Mr. Grove. For decades, Farmington High School has had a proud tradition of welcoming students from all over the world into the high school. These students come to us from Europe and Asia, Africa, South America, and places in between. While their home countries are different, they all come with a common goal and high hopes of engaging in an American high school experience. They participate in sports and in the arts, homecoming, prom, and any number of other high school activities. Continuing a tradition established about a decade ago, we have welcomed these students to participate in our graduation ceremony. While not receiving an official Farmington High School diploma, we hope the experiences, the friendships, the learning, and a certificate of attendance will provide another memory of the time spent with us. Our students have already made their way to the stage. If you would, will you please help me in giving them a hearty round of applause? First, we have Floortje Janssen from the Netherlands. Natalie Chihulova from the Czech Republic. Lisa Bachelet from France. Nadoa Cariaga Lana from Spain. And Julia Gonzalez Fuster from Spain. Congratulations to our foreign exchange students. Seniors, now it's your turn. You've met the requirements of the state of Minnesota and Independent School District 192. Superintendent Berg and members of the Board of Education, by the authority vested in me as interim principal of Farmington High School, I certify that the members of the class of 2023 have completed all requirements and are declared eligible to receive a diploma. Parents, students, friends, and family members, I will once ask you again, just one last time, for your help in making sure that each one of our graduates hears their name as well as their family hears their name. They want to hear it loud and clear. So if you would please all hold, if you would please hold all your applause until the final student's name has been read. Chair Christensen, Board of Members, and the members of the school board, are we ready for the presentation of diplomas? Let's get this party started.
Joel Daniel Abi.
Michaela Ryan Giller.
Hannah Farah Abshir.
Matthew Dylan Gokul.
Amira Muhammad Ali.
Riley June Tui.
Lydia Bell Allison.
Lawrence David Trapp.
Allison Christine Amsler.
Jack James Triple.
Ellie Grace Anderson.
Isabella Marie Schockert.
Jake Jeffrey Anderson.
Jillian Marie Tucker.
Nicholas Richard Anderson.
Logan Nicholas Tucker.
Paige Kaylin Anderson.
Wyatt Ulrich.
Stephen King Antwi.
Olivia Grace Urbach.
Veda Francis Arns.
Broden Randall Valentine.
Samuel Christopher Awarder.
Elena Rose Van Heel.
Yesley Avila.
Landon Frederick Van Heel.
Justin Bathor Sinkiri.
Stephanie Vang.
Angelica Barajas.
Oscar Vasquez.
Amber Rose Barber.
Betseda Vasquez Ramirez.
Jonathan Morales.
Jazz Ann Vick.
Haley Michelle Bastier.
Andrew Joseph Beavering.
Sophia Rose Baum.
Matthew Vogel.
Mika Warren Benning.
Vincent Von Bank.
Jack Richard Bennis.
Kristen Von Krishan Sin.
Carter Ryan Berglund.
Mason Wolf.
Aiden Jacob Bergstrom.
Logan Jacob Wagner.
Peyton Reese Berriman.
Riley Christine Wagner.
Nora Schumann.
Adma Joel Warwick.
Samantha Nguyen.
Kylie May Ann.
Josie Ann Rankala.
Baden Gage Bean.
Liana Elise Sauter.
Jace Ryan Bessler.
Alex Gregory Giddings.
Trinity Ann Lynn Beerworth.
Alex Stephen Gifford.
Connor Nicholas Bigawet.
Caden Richard Reesgraff.
Sean Robert Blackmore.
Carter John Reesgraff.
Rachel Nicole Blazing.
Mason Ray Risto.
Xander Rags Bulches.
Lillian Monica Robinson.
Gavin Maurice Borman.
Mia Sharon Robinson.
Hannah Elizabeth Brunig.
Adeline Rose Roger.
Grace Catherine Brown.
Daniel Reed Rogers.
Casey Elizabeth Brown.
Christopher William Rodriguez.
Chloe Olivia Buckman.
Jordan Liani Rojas.
Caleb Edward Booty.
Taylor Nicole Rondo.
Abigail Louise Burrish.
Josephine Renee Rother.
Shelby Marie Burns.
Zachary Brett Rulo.
Jaden Michael Cowie.
Angelina Justine Russo.
Sabrina Eileen Campbell.
Alexis Renee Rubin.
Josiah Asiel Campos.
Esmeralda Ruby Marcelino.
Jaden Matthew Carlson.
Tate Michael Rusnako.
Madison Ray Carlson.
Natalie Ann Rutz.
Emily Marie Kerrigan.
Abigail Elizabeth Ryan.
Julia Ann Cashman.
Hannah Marie Ryan.
Angel Gabriel De La Pena.
Madison Rose Ryan.
Larry De La Torre.
Dante Shernia Saker.
Hoven Mohammed Sheikh Abdi.
Esmeralda Salgado Reyes.
Gabriel Exel Garahi.
Fred Joseph Sands.
Abby Renee Gerke.
Yvonne Paulette Saucier.
Alyssa Geiken. Peyton Burt Guduto.
Nanda Moe.
Ethan Thomas Gonzi.
Ashley Kwambalka Mogaka.
Julia Ruby Gordon.
Ellie Mogensen.
Kiera Nicole Gordon.
Vedanand Mohanlal.
Trevor Cole Graham.
Braden Moore.
Emily Lynn Greiner.
Evelyn Grace Montgomery.
Caleb Thomas Griffin.
Frank James Mooney.
Sarah Catherine Griffith.
Ethan Modry.
Olivia Joyce Gustafson.
Jason Michael Mersola.
Anna Gute.
Dante Liddell Mulkey.
Kanan Gute.
Brooke Elizabeth Muller.
Ava Ruth Hall.
Michael Bernard Murphy.
Tyler Wayne Hulse.
Ryan Murphy.
Daniel David Halverson.
Sarah Chanda Musanda.
Rosalind Claire Hammond.
John Douglas Navratil.
Hannah Joe Hammer.
Brianna Grace Nelson.
Owen Morris Hammond.
Josh Nelson.
Piper Nicole Hanley.
Kendall Nelson.
Haley Paige Hansen.
Matthew Michael Newbert.
Caitlin Ray Hansen.
Hannah Newman.
Logan Wayne Hansen.
Botron Nguyen.
Brooke Catherine Harum.
Emily Kim Nguyen.
Aubrey Jennifer Harrison.
Lacey Mai Nguyen.
Hannah Jean Harvigel.
Ryan Nguyen.
Brock Jason Harvey.
Stephanie De La O Bustamante.
Jacob Ryan Cavanaugh.
Brianna K. Decker.
Valerie Kathleen Caven.
Aubrey Michaela Dice.
Braden Lee Champlin.
Carlos Alberto Del Castillo.
Sam Dwayne Chapman.
Ella Dervishevich.
Ashik Chaudhary.
Madison May Deneen.
Sean Hanzo Chim.
Jacob Diepengrazio.
Ella Jane Kokenauer.
Sean Patrick Dahani.
Benjamin Chungya Coffey.
Jackson David Drager.
Eva Marie Colson.
Isabella Alexa Drummer.
Michaela Hope Connor.
Ellie Lynn Dunnell.
Robert Vernon Conover III.
Charles Yoon Duro.
Chris James Conway.
Daniela Salomet Eads.
Lacey Claire Cook.
Corbin Earp.
Luke Thomas Coolidge.
Connor Bradley Eby.
James Robert Cooper.
Jack Jared Edwardson.
Johan Eli Coronado Musia.
Sophia Empey.
Maxwell Jacob Coyer.
Faith Kevin Evanger.
Haley May Creighton.
Dariana Marie Evans.
Ella Marie Crosby.
Eric George Eversman.
Ashley Stephanie Cruz Gomez.
Riley Eakin.
Joyce Nicole Cubero Malero.
Brandon Michael Farrell.
Zachary Robert Dahl.
Jade Marie Fearing.
Ashley Marie Dandurand.
Claire Rosine Fish.
Gracie Ann Darrington.
Eduardo Flores Mendez.
Cade Jack Fitzloff.
Brooklyn Rose Green.
Reese Whitney Brazook.
Jackson Felt.
David Howdergy.
Haley Darlene Fernandez.
Madeline Jensen.
Haley Ruth Fetzfog.
Isabella Jolie Johnson.
Noah Fettig.
Joel David Johnson.
Holly Ann Foss.
Katie Ann Johnson.
Victoria Ann Haugrud.
Soren Michael Johnson.
Kiera Faith Hawkins.
Will Michael Johnson.
Isabella Paige Heeman.
Jaden Johnston.
Jacob Hernandez.
Kyle Austin Jones.
Esteban Alfonso Hernandez.
Aiden Anthony Jurish.
Abigail Hess.
Madison Marie Catterlick.
Emily Renee Hetland.
McKenna Ann Catterlick.
Gemma J. Hodges.
Dylan Jeffrey Kaiser.
Sawyer Hoffman.
Nikita Kaliv.
Graham Joseph Honitschlager.
Sophia Rose Kalmus.
William James Hornblad.
Riley Michael Casper.
Dalton Dwayne Howie.
Eliana Joy Koffel.
Daisy Ellen Moneypenny Hubert.
Allison Marie Kavitz.
Elijah Hipsch.
Wayne Thomas Keating.
Harper Ray Hutchinson.
Tyler Thomas Keach.
Kai Renee Danielle Jackson.
Derek George Keene.
Kaisi Marie Jacobs.
Andrew Christopher Keeney.
Idea Jacobson Schulte.
Jaden Allen Kempenick.
Faith Ring.
Emily Lynn Sheldon.
Jacob Joseph Foley.
Tahiri Lynn Wheeler.
Andy Robert Cabral Force.
Blake Waltman.
Latea Tajane Liera Johnson.
Luke Walton.
Brianna Lorraine Jones.
Sophia Renee Watkinson.
Haley Marie Kepler.
Abby Warkey.
Nadiro Hawk Condaker.
Tyler Jeffrey Weinberger.
Brendan Aaron Kiefit.
Devin Brian Wensman.
Alex Nelson Kinseth.
Thomas Lee West.
Liam Robert Kirby.
Whitney C. Westland.
Hannah Kirkoff.
Tyrell Wheeler.
Laura Eve Klein.
Colton Michael Whitehill.
Joshua William Klotz.
Alexander Robert Wilkie.
Gavin Christopher Kluver.
Audrey Joanne Wisdorf.
Taylor Coker.
Riley Witten.
Caitlin Kohler.
Morgan Elizabeth Wolt.
Ari Rose Koyman.
Dylan Robert Wolf.
Mitchell Edward Kapersky.
Ian Kirk Wolfgram.
McKenna Rose Koshanina.
Benjamin James Woline.
Jonah David Kragness.
Jennifer P. Shong.
Tabitha Ellen Kramer.
Lana Yang.
Mitchell George Kronbeck.
Isabel Elaine Yarmolich.
Colin Chase Kruger.
Petros Taman Johannes.
Nathan Zachary Kruger.
Zachary Michael Yeomans.
Kat Jolene Cruzy.
Kobe Alexander Young.
Elizabeth Amber Kukas.
Thomas Joseph Zuzek.
Emily Jo Lobbs.
Hannah Renee Helby.
Kylie Victoria Corot.
Katarina Joelle Luchin.
Elizabeth Grace Foss.
Olivia Grace Mackey.
Jacob Scott Frank.
Emily Rose Mafridas.
Benjamin Joseph Gard.
Naimo Mahamud.
Natea Tejane Leana Johnson.
Tabitha Marie Mann.
Lauren Cecilia Lade.
Luis Roberto Manuel Maya.
Jake Anthony Lamberson.
Austin Morris.
Zachary Lamott.
Sarah Marcotte.
Samantha Marie Laramie.
Morgan Christine Madison.
Alexa Lynn Lattes.
Caitlin Maxwell.
Jackson Blake Lauby.
Emily Elizabeth McCabe.
Connor Allen Levine.
Mackenzie Nicole McCarthy.
Eleonora K. Leathers.
Dylan McClure.
Alex Gary Lee.
Megan Grace McConnell.
Josephine Millie Lee.
Jacob McGee.
Tyrus J. Levack.
John Todd McGregor.
Corey James Lay.
Devon Meese.
Megan Grace Liebers.
Campbell Margaret Meyer.
Reese William Linke.
Audrey Rose Meyer.
Alexis Elizabeth Linkert.
Sonia Ann Mahares Herrera.
Amanda Christine Lenz.
Owen Michael Mikolajczyk.
Elise Paulson Lissick.
Jenna Joe Miller.
Danielle Josephine Levecki.
Ryan Mittling.
Ismail Alexander Loa Delgado.
Alexander Thomas Terry.
Juan Eduardo Lopez Jr.
Devin Lee Jurdy.
Anna Marie Lorenzana.
Brett M. Gurman.
Wade Nelson Love.
Mitchell Ryan Getting.
Camille Marie Gerke.
Luke Ryan Harris.
Louis Geiselhart.
Riley Ellen Peterson.
Kyle David Nilsen.
Ryan Dylan Pettis.
Lane Janice Nordmeyer.
Anthony Pham.
Emma Rose Nordstrom.
Charlie William Peer.
Emiliano Nunez Rojas.
Madison Jean Plan.
Jaden Joseph Nunn.
Ryan Dennis Poppin.
Zoe Lynn O'Daniel.
Madeline Marissa Prantner.
Cohen Orvis Elke.
Matthew Allen Price.
Nique Julius Okongo.
Jace Randy Crosser.
Ethan J. Olson.
Alejandro Jose Ramirez.
Isaac Olson.
Katie Ann Rabling.
Tristan Cole Olson.
Abigail Elaine Radesky.
Dakota Jean Olson Smith.
Luke Jones Reed.
Beverly O'Malley.
Charlie John Rehack.
Logan William Upsall.
Caden J. Reichertz.
Danilyn Rose Orth.
Natalie Ray Reller.
Jairo Osorio Oclama.
Matthew Isaiah Remlinger.
Anna May Oster.
Daniela Renteria.
Brett Daniel Ott.
Peyton Allen Reuter.
Jordan John Overman.
Luke Wallace Rice.
Isabel Maria Padilla.
Aiden Daniel Richard.
Layla Pallman.
Nevaeh Richards.
Hannah Lucille Pappas.
Jefferson Manuel Rivas Castro.
Danielle Joe Partington.
Asher Hollis Quinn.
Olivia Grace Pattengill.
McKenna Eileen Saul.
Nicholas Paul Pena.
Ashton Anusith Sam.
Elijah Todd Perkinson.
Annabelle Jean Specken.
Brianne Maggie Duwilde.
Paige Elizabeth Stafford.
Brielle Nicole Field.
Emily Grace Stankey.
Emery Roosevelt Hardin.
Nicholas Edward Stangler.
Soren Hipsch.
Brady Brian Steinert.
Elena May Morrow.
Ethan Robert Stender.
Carly Joe Schachtel.
Megan Patricia Stoa.
Owen Marcus Schmidt.
Sarah Beth Stoa.
Jordan Elizabeth Schmucker.
Ava Jacqueline Sullivan.
Caroline Lorraine Scholl.
Kia Janelle Tackett.
Kyler J. Schwamm.
Gabriella Faith Talley.
Haley Marie Scott.
Talesh Nikhil Tarchand.
Christopher James Shanks.
Hunter Dean Taylor.
Mason Philip Shaver.
Kinsley Lynn Taylor.
Caitlin Gabrielle Shear.
Olivia Barbara Thurl.
Cody Allen Shoyat.
Haley Christine Thielen.
Jonathan Calvin Potabom Schrum.
Hudson Jean Thomas.
Gavin Joseph Sickman.
Benjamin Donald Thompson.
Rory Lee Seachlog.
Nathan Mark Tidd.
Nick Simon.
Connor Alfred Todd.
Parker Sinner.
Jacob Patrick Tui.
Morgan Paige Scarry. Miranda Elizabeth Smith. Mitchell Allen Smith. Anthony Soak.
Ella Rose Carvel. Kenya Marie Davis. Tanyu Nguyen. Riley Kleeberger. Zachary John Mix. Tyler Robert Patterson. Last on our list, but first in our hearts, Hunter Lee Schneider.
Well, there they are, class of 2023. Take a look at them. Yeah, get your cameras ready, because this is going to be the most spectacular shot you're going to get tonight. Will the class of 2023 please rise? Seniors, if you've not already done so, please move your tassel from the right side to the left. Class of 2023, you did it. Family members and members of the community, I present to you the Farmington High School Class of 2023. Seniors, you are now officially graduated. Toss those caps.